Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Today I have an iDefine wig. It's 150% density, a body wave in the inch 20 inches, and it's a 360 lace frontal wig. I do want to say this wave pattern is absolutely gorgeous. This is the body wave, but wait till y'all see it at the end. It's absolutely gorgeous. So I do have my cap molded down, y'all. I did try in the back, so you know, don't come for me. But I did go ahead and put the concealer all over my lace in the front before I do try to apply my wig. And y'all, this is a light brown, kind of medium lace wig. It looks more transparent. I believe it may be transparent. I will leave everything down in the description box for y'all to see. But I am going to go ahead and try to fit this on my head to see exactly where I need to place it. So this wig fits perfectly on my head. I am gonna take my scissors and cut off the ear tabs first. That is the first step you need to do, is cut out your ear tabs so it can really fall in place. Once you have the ear tabs cut off, you still need to align it up to make sure everything fits properly. This wig does come pre-plucked, but I did go ahead and pluck some more. As y'all can see in the back, I did pluck the back and I removed the bands that was in the back so it can lay down flat. But I am gonna cut off extra lace from the front because y'all, it was touching my lashes, and y'all know I don't need my lashes falling off on this video. So I did cut off extra and I'm just fitting it on where I want it to be. I do start it off with Bold Hold. This is Bold Hold Active for a secure hold. And I go over it 3 times. Make sure that glue is all the way dry. I have problems around my ear tab parts when it dries, so I do go back and work on that a little bit more. But as far as the front, you want to make sure it's completely dry before placing the wig down. Once it is placed down, you want to just take it and secure it into the glue. I actually take my hot comb. You can use just a fine tooth comb, but you need to just take a comb and secure it into the glue. I usually go over it with Got to Be Glue for that extra hold. I am going to take my elastic band and press it down. Now, I only do the front first and then I do the back, because you want to make sure there is a hold and that your front is secure before you work on the back. I take my blow dryer, and I can't remember where my blow dryer is from. I will leave it down in the description box, but I go ahead and blow dry my whole head because y'all, I did just recently wash this hair. But I am going to just make sure everything is completely dry. That is the goal, for your lace to be completely dry. So now that it's dry, I take my elastic band off, and you know, look at them hairs, like, y'all, this is laid already. So I'm very excited. But I am going to go in and cut off my lace in the front. And I do cut it in different sections because it is a lot easier, just in case you need more baby hairs or you need a thicker hairline in one certain area. Try doing it in sections and work on one section at a time. So I am going to cut off my first tab, and like I already stated earlier, that my ear tabs are like the hardest spots for me. So I do go back in later and put I do go back with Bold Hold and dry it and then do those steps all over again. I am taking my eyebrow razor and cutting off my lace. It is very easy to cut it off with an eyebrow razor than scissors, but it's your own preference. Do whatever you want to do. But y'all, look at this lace. Like, I don't know if this is HD, but this lace on this wig is probably the best I ever had. Look how it just melts into my skin. And I haven't even finished yet. Like, I can walk out just like this. But I am going to go back with my ear tabs because, y'all, I can't be, you know, I like to be putting my hair behind my ears, and I ain't trying to have nothing fly away. So I do go back and spread it on, and then I go back with my blow dryer and make sure that it is securely down. I don't need nothing to be flipping and flapping. I'm going to make sure my ear tabs are secure down. And once that is done, y'all, my wig is a lay to the gods. Like, it is completely laid. I'm gonna go and clean it up because there is extra lace. Y'all can't even see it, but there is extra lace I'm cutting off. Y'all, that's how good this wig is. Y'all can't even see the extra lace, but it's there, and I'm gonna cut it off like nobody even knew. And I do have to mention, excuse the way I'm looking right now, it's like 10, 11 o'clock at night, and I gotta get cute for the next day. Y'all, it's the weekend, and we gotta get this all together. So excuse the way I'm looking, but back to this wig. I'm just trying to fix all the little touches before I start on the back. Now the back is the tricky part, and if you do have someone who can help you, please find that someone, because I did mess up a little bit on the back, but I tried. That's all that matter. I tried. But if you have someone who can help you on the back, please have that person help you. But I did do my back by myself for the very first time. I'm gonna take the same exact steps I did for the front. I put down bow hold. I did it about 2 times, not 3 times. But I did put bow hold down because I ain't want my back to stay on forever. But I did put down bow hold. I am gonna blow dry and make sure it's dry completely before laying my lace down. Y'all see this? Y'all, it look good already, but wait. Y'all, like I said, I had trouble. But once I put it down, I am gonna go in with my Gotta Be Free spray, put my elastic band down, and I am gonna put my elastic band the opposite way so it does lay down flat in the back. I am gonna go back and blow dry it. Once it blow dries completely, and then I will cut off the lace. So once I do have it dried in the back, I am going to take my scissors this time and cut off my lace. And I chose my scissors because y'all don't want to take that razor and actually cut off like your baby hairs that may still be left out in the back of your hair. So that's why I chose my scissors, so I can really feel and know what I'm cutting. And while that's actually setting in place, I'm going to work on my front. This wig is so thick in the frontal part. So thick. I mean, the wig is thick all the way around where the lace is at. Y'all can barely see the part, I mean. So I did go in and pluck that part again. But it looks good, but I like it a little bit thicker where you can actually see and look more realistic. That look like a line. I mean, it's supposed to be a line, but y'all get what I'm saying. So I did go back and pluck the part. And I just take my hot comb and just brush everything back, because I'm going to do simple baby hairs today. And I'm going to just take 2 out where my temples are and just form those baby hairs. Now, y'all be careful with these hot combs, because I did just burn my hair right then and there. You know, y'all can see it all in my face. But I am just going to take these 2 baby hairs where my temples is at, comb all of that back, and just go ahead and mold it. Now, one side looks like it's plucked a lot, and then the other one is barely plucked. So what I did, I just went back and plucked the other side a little bit more to try to match it up a little bit, or I try to do the best I can, because it's a lot harder plucking it while it's on your head versus when it's off, because you can really like move it around and compare. But when it's on your head, like, you try not to rip the lace while plucking, even though you can just have it a certain way. But I'm right-handed, so it was just really hard. But I did go ahead and pluck it a little bit more on that side and try to match it up the best I can. And I did go ahead and mold my baby hairs after that. Now, I did go ahead and cut baby hairs in the back, and one mistake that I didn't take out enough hair in the back at all. So if y'all need, like, don't really pluck the back as much, because unless you have somebody else helping you putting it down. But if you're doing it by yourself, don't pluck the back so much, because it's not like the front. You know, you need all that hair to cover up any kind of mistake you have. So I did pluck the back a little bit too much, and I couldn't really mold down my baby hairs like I wanted to. But y'all, these baby hairs cute, so I am gonna just take my ear tabs and mold that down and cut it and get those right. And I also take my mousse to mold it down, and I use Nairobi mousse for molding my baby hairs down, and I also use that in the back as well. And I am gonna go ahead and do that, and I am going to spray it over just in case. I do like that extra hole, y'all. I'm not trying to have my wig going nowhere at all. My wig cannot go nowhere. So I spray it down one more time just for security and put my elastic band back on, and we're gonna get this thing going. Are y'all ready for the end results? I don't think y'all ready. Y'all ready? Okay, here we go. Here we go. It's coming. It's coming. So if nobody ever told you, but girl, you look good. I mean, you look good. You look so good. Do y'all not see this? Oh my gosh. Like, if nobody told you today, like, somebody should be praising the ground you walk on. Like, you are gorgeous. Gorgeous. Do you not see this laid wig, y'all? This is melted to perfection. I define wig, y'all. This is it right here. Y'all seen it for yourself. Like, this is it. This is it. So if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please do that now. Like this video, tell me how I did, and thank y'all again for watching.